हेलो क्लास फोर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय न्यू सेशन ऑफ चैप्टर फोर ऑफ क्लास फोर मैथमेटिक्स, दैट इज एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन. स्टूडेंट्स, आई नो यू आर जस्ट थिंकिंग अबाउट कि एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन, दिस एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन वी हैव ऑलरेडी डन. व्हाई मैम इज अगेन टेकिंग दिस चैप्टर? स्टूडेंट, दिस टाइम दिस इज अगेन कम इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कंबाइंड ऑपरेशन. Addition and subtraction means this is a combined operation of addition and subtraction. Operation means plus and minus, they are come in one questions together. This is also called the simplify the questions or solve the questions. When the question is written simplify, it means two or more than two operations are given. So first we are just find out how to do the two operations together. But student, there is a one rule for that. Whenever addition and subtraction are given together in any expression, in any question, right? Addition and subtraction together, then the first step is always first add the number. And the second step is subtract. This is first number and this is on second number, right? But one more important point is that should be remember, everyone, you have to remember that point. Suppose if word problem is there and then two operations are given together. Suppose one word problem is there with you, right? And in that question, subtraction come first and addition is on the second position. Then you have to follow the sequence. In simplification, always follow addition first, subtraction on the second step. But if in word problem, any word problem is there and then you have to solve the word problem, then follow the sequence, whatever the sequence, addition is first or subtraction is first, whatever the sequence, then you have to follow the sequence. Let's take one example. Suppose your question is simplify. Simple, simplification is there, the question is simplify and the number is 36 plus 48 minus 15. This is your question. Simplify here, two operations now together. Two operations are together. There is a combined operation, addition and subtraction. Then what is the way to solve this question? Step 1, you have to use the steps here. First of all, according to the rule I have already explained with you, whenever the questions come in the form of solve or simplification, you have to follow add first and then subtract. So this is the first step, 36 plus 48. The answer is 14, 1 carry, 84. Now you have to take this number on the next right to make the step 2. So 84 is the answer, right? 84 on the top and now this is a this number minus 15 here. Student, we have already know how to subtract. If the minority is smaller, make it 14 and this is 7. 14 minus 5, 9, right? And 7 minus 1, 6. So 69 is the answer. This is the way to how to do the two operations together. Okay, let's take one more example. Why I taken this example? Because in this example, in this question, this subtraction comes from first position and addition is on second place. But student, this is a simplification, so you have to again follow the rule. First add the numbers. Student, one important point I want to tell you, that this number is a positive number. No sign is there, it means this is a positive number. This is also a positive number and this is a negative number. So first we have to add all the positive numbers. Positive numbers, those numbers who is having the plus sign. If no sign is there, then it means that is also a positive number. So again, step 1, 598, this is a positive number. You have to first add this number. This is a negative number, so this is on the come second. This is in the second step. First we add this number, 77. You can change the order of the numbers. This is 15, 1 carry. Now 17, 1 carry, 675. Now again just the same second step is there. Write this 675 as a minute. Now what is the subtrahend here? This minus 286. Student, don't be so confused. Whenever the question comes, you can just see the question, which operation comes on first position or second position. Simplification or solve, you have to add first numbers. You have to add the numbers first and then subtract the numbers. Doesn't matter whether it is on a second position or on a third position. So now 15 minus 6 is 9. Here it comes 6 and 16. So 16 minus 8 is 8, and 5 minus 3 is, sorry, 5 minus 2 is 3. So 389 is the answer. I hope you understand with these two examples. In the first example, the second number is an addition number, positive number. And the third one is a negative number. But in this example, the second number is a negative number and third is a positive number. So first I add this number and this number. First we take the addition, first we add the numbers, and then we'll move to the next step, that is a subtraction. Make sure, student, don't be so confused. Don't make it a addition or positive. Don't change the signs of the number. If you change the sign of the number, your question is totally wrong. Now student, the next topic is two steps word problem. Student, as you know that subtraction is the opposite of addition, right? In real life, these two operations exist together on many occasions. Like in this question, let's first read out the question. There were 3,758 males and 1,685 females in a town in the beginning of the year. In the beginning of the year, which means when this year starts. 615 people died during the year. In the whole year, during the year, 615 people died. Find the population of the town at the end of the year. When the year ends, how much people are left in that town? So student, this is a combined operation. Males and females, first we have to find out how many total people are there in the town, and then we have to take difference of this number, those who are died, and then we'll calculate the number of people left in the town at the end of the year. So student, first of all, what we have to find here? We have to find this 3758 plus 1685 minus 615. Student, this is why we are putting the bracket here. We are using this bracket just to indicate that which operations comes on the first position, right? We are putting the bracket just to tell you about that, to indicate which operations will be done on the first position or will be done first. That's why we are putting the bracket here. Bracket means we have to first solve this addition, and then after adding these two numbers, then we'll take the difference of this number. Now students, we have to write the statement also. Why? Because this is a word problem. So what is the first we have to frame the statement for this, and then we'll go on this one. So let's do the solution here. Step 1 is addition and step 2 is subtraction. So let's write the statement here. Number of males are 3758. You can write like ones, tens, hundred, thousand. Now number of females, they are 1685. So this is the addition. Let's find out what is the sum of these two numbers. 8 plus 5, how much children? 13 plus 1 carry there. Then 14, 1 carries again here, then 14 and 1 carries there, and then this is. So they are total number of people. This is step 1 students. Now students, step 1 is done. Now move to the step 2. You have to mention here step 1, step 2. Now what is the step 2 here? We have first do the addition is done. One operation is done. One more addition is left, that is subtraction. Now total number of people. Now again make the statement for this one also. Total number of people, they are how many? This is 5, 4, 4, 3. Ones, tens, hundred, and thousand. Now they are the total number of people in the town. How many people were died? 615. Number of people died, they are 615. The one is a 4-digit number and the another one is a 3-digit number. No problem student, let's start the subtraction. This 3 is smaller than 5, so make it a bigger number by taking help from here. Now it becomes 3. Let's do it for this one. 13 minus 5, What is the answer, student? What is the answer? Yes. 8 is the answer. Now 3 and 1, they are easily subtract because 3 is bigger number. 3 minus 1 is 2. Now again just move to the 100 number, 100 place. 4 is again smaller than 6. So let's take help from 1000 place. Now 14 minus 6. Again this is 8. And now 4 is left. There is no number, so we can note down the 4 number as it is. So they are the number of people left in the town at the end of the year. So let and the end, you have to, what we have to write here. So 4828 people left in the town at the end of the year. Children, in this way we can do the both the operations together one by one, step one and step two. Now student, this is the next topic, that is framing story sum. You have already done this activity in our Zoom session. One by one you have framed the question, framed the word problems once on addition and then subtraction also. Now again I have given an addition or subtraction fact for you, and now you have to find out which operation is there, and then you have to frame the story sum, or we can say that word problem. So my first fact is, suppose my is 53 students in a school bus This is my fact. One fact is there. So first we have to find out, is this an addition fact or a subtraction fact? 15 students in a school bus, 15 got down. So this is a subtraction fact. So how many are left in the school bus? So how can we make the, there are 53 students in a school bus, out of them 13 got down. So find out the remaining number of students left in the bus. Now student, this is a fact. Now you have to write the question for this. This is a solution. This is a solution and you have to frame the question for this. So there are 53 students in a school bus. Out of them 13 got down. How many students are left in the school bus? Now in this way, but only you just have to frame the word problem. No solution and nothing is there. Okay student, only framing story sums. This is a fact and then you have to frame the question. First you understand what is the fact. Either it is an addition or a subtraction. Now student, let's take one more example. This is another fact. Let's see which is this fact, is addition or subtraction. 114 blue pens and 278 red pens in a shop. Oh yes, I understand this is an addition fact. Now student, how we frame the story from for this? In a shop there are 114 blue pens, itne red pens, so find the total number of pens in the shop. So in this way you can frame, you can change the language also, you can use another way also, that is your choice. The statements, the story sum may be different. It's not be always equal, is order not same as my one. So you can frame your story from sums according to the facts. So I hope you understand this session. Three topics I have cleared. One is simplification, then word problems of two operations together, and the third one is framing story sum. Thank you student for this session.